Dominicans in Rwanda. Gospel Meditation, Saturday, 15th week in Ordinary Time, year 2020. The Ethics of Predation. Brothers and sisters, we live in a country where the scarcity of land creates lust and sometimes causes conflicts, even crimes difficult to prevent or to unmask. The perpetrators of this land mischief often spend a lot of time plotting from the bottom of their beds against poor people. The prophet Micah reminds us that these injustices linked to the ownership of land and houses annoy the Lord. God plans revenge against these structural sins. Those who strip others will be stripped in turn. Similarly, conflicts of socio-cultural nature draw certain people around us into outrages of all kinds. For instance, just as Jesus is hunted down by the Pharisees until he is forced to flee, so many men and women around us may feel threatened, hunted down, and driven to flight for reasons that irritate our God. Houses, lands, or other heritage coveted by their antagonists, socio-cultural disagreements, conflicts and structural sins, predation and theft in all its forms. Woe to those who take part. The prophet Micah and the evangelist Matthew warn us. Whoever ruminates and executes evil against his neighbor will never enjoy lasting peace. A deep fragility is already eating away at the bottom of the skinning predators. God takes charge of their brutal fall. He meditates against this spawn, a misfortune where they will sink to the neck. Rather than learning this harmful ethics of predation and pillage, today's readings invite us to become servants chosen by God, to take part in the well-being of our most vulnerable neighbors, to help the crumpled reed with injustices from our world. Brothers and sisters, let us fight to become beloved ones of God. We are beloved of God when we practice the benevolence and charity of Jesus towards those who seek help and consolation from us. We are from the ethics of charity, not of the ethics of predation. May God preserve us from all evil. May He make us true instruments of His justice in this world. Amen.